Kick off your week by installing your game plan. Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features one team who likes to get it done through the air. The Falcons are number one in total pass yards, going up against the Bucs, who will have to be at their best to slow them down.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They'll be led out by their now third-year QB, the number one overall pick back in 2015. From Florida State, it's Jameis Winston.
You talk about the pause that refreshes. I think it's come at a perfect time of the year for them, hasn't it? You know, the season is starting to wind down, got a little bit of a break. But how about the guy calling the signals? He's got to be excited about that because now he didn't just get a game plan for 1 week. He's able to work on it for 2 weeks. I can't wait to see if they have anything special in store for him today.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Play fake to Martin. Now Jameis. And that is incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it'll bring up third down. Working out of the gun. Winston. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Grady Jarrett in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. And the sack parade continues. Remember last week, they had an astounding 8 sacks, another one there on the opening drive.
And they have the mentality of just attacking the quarterback in the pocket, no matter what. They're one of those teams that says, we play the run on our way back to the quarterback. And that philosophy works for them very well.
A great return there of 22 yards. And the Falcons are set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
A good pickup there of 20 yards. Sensational he was last week, over 200 yards. And the simple quote that we saw this week was, keep him in front of us. They're going to have to do that.
And
he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons have taken the early lead.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and he'll take over at the 25. Now the first carry for Doug Martin. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Well, I better raise my voice a little bit here because one thing we can already tell, even in the first year in the league with this new stadium, it's going to get loud in this place.
Yeah, the old place was loud, but I think we're getting a sense that this place is going to be louder.
Yeah, they're riding that momentum of that 2016 team that finished their year in the Super Bowl.
This is brought in at the 21. Oh, able to avoid him. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Falcons will be taking over 1st and 10. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. That'll bring up 2nd down. But in tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just one.
Is that what they say?
There it is. You know, put a little sand down on the stage.
I'll take your word for it, my man. So 2nd down was a run play. Now let's see what they do on 3rd. Freeman again. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. The Falcons averaged 34 points a game last year, tops in the NFL with that powerful offense, and they're already looking for more here as they've got it first and 10. Here's Ryan, forced out to his left, getting it out left side to Sanu, and he is knocked down from the side at the 19. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you've got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line.
Yeah, and that was the safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. And we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I think of Tevin Coleman as a really good combo back. He can run it, but in terms of being a third down back, I think he ranks with the best in the league.
So good at leaking out of the backfield. Ryan finding him there for the Falcons first. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll look to run with Freeman. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well, Red.
Yeah, thank you. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to 3rd and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up 3rd.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
A field goal would make it a 2-score game, but they're going to go aggressive. They're going to try this thing on 4th and goal. They'll run it. Freeman. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the 1. Freeman unable to get free here on 4th and goal. And the Bucs defense, they'll celebrate the goal line stand. Though certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on 4th.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise.
Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points. Well, if you haven't gotten enough football this Thanksgiving weekend, there's still more to come. Tonight,
yes,
you're pumped up. It's 2 of the most storied franchises in NFL history doing battle. The Packers, he's got it at the 15. And he gets this down deep into Tampa Bay territory. A big-time play there for the Falcons. And even 50 yards. They go play action here on 1st down, eluding the pressure right. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. Matt Ryan with his 2nd touchdown here in this 1st half. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Second down, Winston. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Give him six on the play, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. Now a play fake to Martin. Here's Winston. Losing 6 yards there to bring up fourth. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Here's Brian Anger now as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line. And tough starting field position here. Freeman here to begin the drive. And they'll get him down up past the 15. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Freeman again, a first down carry. And he goes across the 20 to the 22. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. Second down following the run. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Buying time to his left. Looking deep for Julio. It's caught inside the 25. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out to start the third quarter?
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Falcons are happy to be in front, and they'll look to play another solid half of football. The Buccaneers know it's always hard to come in and get a win on the road, but they're not out of this one yet. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. First and 10, Ryan's gonna find his mark, and this goes 17 yards for the score as they get out to a 7-0 lead. Now first and 10. The deep ball is on target here, and he ends up at the 14-yard line before he stopped on the play. Later on the drive, Ryan's looking for room to run, and this run goes for a touchdown. That pushes the lead to 16. Falcons have it on 2nd and 5. Jones is wide open down the field, and he'll take this all the way for a touchdown.
All right, Larry, indeed a one-sided affair to this point. As we get set for half two, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. Almost unstoppable on the ground there as that one is good for 39.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Noah Spence in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even...
And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Falcons add on.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Ready, blue lady.
Winston gives to Martin on the draw. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that's going to lead to a third and 12.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think for the offensive coordinator, he's going to go to that side.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Grady Jarrett in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
This is fielded at the 27. He won't go down. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball.
And this is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Mohamed Sanu. His sixth touchdown of the season, and the Falcons continue to pour it on.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. You might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Winston. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Third and short yardage, Winston. And he's got a man. It's the tight end, Howard, complete. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back.
Roger, Roger. Ready. Move ready.
On first and 10, Winston. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Grady Jarrett in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Now a second down throw for Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. That catch good for five. It's third down.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. Third and long for Winston. And it's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up fourth. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Taking it about the 16. And he's going to be out of bounds right at the 40. Time for a break. This one all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Ryan wants to throw it. Rolling to his right. And off his back. It's caught inside the 25. They give him a gain of 38. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Steps away to his left. And his throw here is incomplete.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
Flush to his right. That is caught at the 7. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 18 yards the gain for number 18. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And they are just not going to let up as he is into the end zone here for two more.
Partner, they're up big. They snapped the ball from the 15 for a regular PAT. Yet they fake it and get it. Is the kicker's leg tired? What's going on here?
I don't know, but defensively, now with this deficit, now you had two more onto that. They faked the PAT. That stings a little.
It definitely stings, and I know the guys that I played for, they wouldn't be as mad at the opposition as they would have been at us for allowing that to happen.
First down, Winston. And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Dontari Poe in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Winston from the gun on third down. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. And it's a 15-yard pickup, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, of that marker. Jameis to throw it. He's got Evans. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Jameis now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Now Jameis on second down. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Great change up there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside, make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him and the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
Meanwhile, in Foxborough, they're in the fourth quarter. And the Dolphins have gone out in front late over the Patriots. Jay Cutler, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one.